Hey everyone, my name is Kuba Campbell and I'm a licensed trauma therapist, writer, speaker, and the founder of the Healing Circle Therapy and Wellness Center here in Charlotte, North Carolina. And I have the honor of sharing the verse of the day from Romans 12, 12. Rejoice in hope, be patient in affliction, be persistent in prayer. So as a therapist, if I want to practice as a therapist, I have to abide by a code of ethics, which is just a set of moral principles that I have to govern my activity and my actions by. We find this verse smack dab in the middle of the code of ethics that Paul is writing to the church. He is writing this section saying, hey, this is how you should govern yourselves. This is how you should show up in the world. This is how you should act as believers. So what is he saying to us? He's saying rejoice in hope. Not in circumstance, not in opportunities, not in accolades, not in ease, not in things going well, but rejoice in hope, in the hope we have in Jesus that's everlasting, that can never be taken away from us, the hope that we know is established and rooted and eternal. He's telling us to be patient in affliction, to follow in the footsteps of Jesus, of suffering well and walking through the darkness into the light and the eternal glory that we get to partake in with him when we are patient in affliction, to be persistent in prayer, to keep our hearts connected to God even when we feel like he's far away, to cry out to him like we would a child calling out for their father, because we know that he'll respond even if he doesn't respond the way that we want him to. This is how we govern ourselves as Christians. This is how we show up in our everyday lives. We rejoice in a hope, even if we can't see it. We are patient in affliction, knowing that we will be saved, knowing that we will not be put to shame, and knowing that we will know the glory and the goodness of the Lord here in this life. And we are to be persistent in prayer as we attune our hearts and our ears to the sound of heaven, to the sound of a good father, so that we can be transformed into his likeness and be lamps on hills, showing the world that there is a hope in the midst of darkness. So my prayer for you is that you would rejoice in the hope of something that is not established yet, that you would be patient in the affliction that you're enduring in and out of season, and that you would be persistent in prayer, even when it feels like God's being silent. Be blessed.